modern periodic law and the present form of the periodic table. Okay, so this is the next concept. Here I want to explain you what do you mean by periodic table and the modern periodic law I will explain you. Okay, so we must bear in mind that when Mendeleev developed his periodic table, okay, we are familiar with the Mendeleev's law now. So when Mendeleev developed his periodic table, chemists knew nothing about the internal structure of atoms. Okay, when Mendeleev proposed the periodic table, they don't have any idea about internal structure of atoms. However, the beginning of the 20th century witnessed profound developments in theories about subatomic particles. There is a CEO when the Mendeleev he developed when the periodic table, Mendeleev periodic table we are calling, okay. So at that time they don't have the idea about internal structure of atoms, okay. So however, in the beginning of the 20th century, next they came to know that there is a subatomic particles. You know, I think, so what do you mean by subatomic particles, correct? And the next thing is, in 1913, the English physicist Henry observed regularities in the characteristics X-ray spectra of elements. Okay, so Henry observed regularities in the characteristics X-ray spectra of elements. A plot of square root of V against atomic number Z gave a straight line and not the plot square root of V versus atomic mass. Okay, so what I am explaining you here means, see here, a plot of square root of V and which is against the atomic number, means which is nothing but Z, you know, I think so the atomic number is Z. Okay, so square root of V versus, means square root of V versus Z, okay, so give a straight line, okay, which gives when we draw a plot square root of V versus atomic mass, okay, so there we will not get a straight line. Okay, he thereby showed that the atomic number is a more fundamental property of element than its atomic mass. So from this he observed that when we are doing square root of V versus atomic number, we will get a, as I have explained, that we will get a straight line, correct? So is thereby atomic number is, now we can say that the atomic number is more fundamental property of an element than its atomic mass. Okay, so atomic number is more fundamental, okay, properties of an element than its atomic mass, we can say like that. Mendeleev's periodic law was therefore accordingly modified. This is known as the modern periodic law. Okay, so Mendeleev's law, which is modified, according which is modified, this is known as modern periodic law. The physical and chemical properties of the elements are periodic functions of their atomic numbers. Okay, so you may recall that the atomic number is equal to the nuclear charge or the number of protons in a neutral atom, correct? Then Okay, so I think so you have some idea about long periodic table. If you don't know, means just consider here a modern version, the so-called long form of the periodic table, okay, of the elements is the most convenient and widely used. The horizontal rows are called periods and the vertical columns are called groups. Okay, see here. Horizontal, please note it down. Horizontal rows, they are called what, you know, they are called periods. Okay, so then vertical columns, they are called groups. Okay, so element having similar outer electronic configurations in their atoms are arranged in vertical columns referred to as a groups or families. Okay, so this is means just consider this as the periodic table. Okay, so as the horizontal, these are called the periods. Okay, and the vertical columns are called groups. Okay, this is about the modern periodic law and the present form of the periodic table. So later on I will explain you about nomenclature and the modern form of the periodic table. Okay, next topic is nomenclature of elements with atomic number greater than 100. The elements, new elements with very high atomic numbers, they are so unstable. Okay, they are having very high atomic numbers, are so unstable. Okay, scientists before collecting the reliable data on the new element at times get tempted to claim for its discovery. For example, what is happening while discovering the new elements, means both American and Soviet scientists claimed credit for discovering the element 104. So there is a discovery of element, there was during that there's a when disclaimed. Okay, the Americans named it as a rutherfordium. Americans named it as what? Rutherfordium. Okay, so whereas the Soviets, who they named it as a kurchatovium. To avoid what is that, the American is giving another one name and the Soviets, they giving another name. Okay, so this is difficult to identify. So to avoid such problems, the IUPAC has made recommendation that until a new element's recognized, okay, when until the new element's recognized, a systematic nomenclature be derived directly from the atomic number of the element using numerical roots for zero and numbers 1 to 9. Okay, so they should be, IUPAC is suggesting that what the IUPAC has made a recommendation that until a new element's discovery is proved and its name is officially recognized, the systematic nomenclature be derived directly from the atomic number of the elements using numerical roots for zero. Okay, so as shown in the table, I will explain you, this is the table, consider. So before going to that, okay, so this is in this table, consider here. So the roots are put together in order of digits which make up the atomic number, and IUM is used at the end. Okay, like consider this as the zero digit, zeroth, right? See, this is a zero which is nil. Okay, and where it is represented as N. So the IUPAC names for the elements with the Z above 100 are also shown. So this is the digit 0, means for 1 you are writing UN and U, like 2 you are writing by. So then this is a B, then like tri T, quad Q, like that up to digits 9 you are writing like this. Okay, so how you are writing means, consider in that then up greater than 100 how you will write. So this is the greater than 100, as I explained you about this is UN is what, un is 1, okay, un. For 1 you are writing un, for 0 you are writing nil, okay. Then uni, again 1 is un, ium is the last, you should add ium. Like that, un for 1 un writing, for 0 you are writing nil, and for 2 you are writing by b, and then the last is ium, again you are writing. Like that, up to here you are writing 118. So how you are writing about this, okay? In that they may ask you question, how to write in IUPAC the nomenclature of elements with atomic number above 100. So this is about the above 100, how they can be represented, okay? This is the modern periodic law, modern periodic table, okay? I will explain you it in detail, okay? And that is about greater than 100. Thus, the new elements gets a temporary name with symbol consisting of three elements like this, okay? Later, permanent name and symbol are given by vote of IUPAC representative from each country. The permanent name might reflect the country in which the element was discovered, or pay tribute to a notable scientist. As of now, elements with atomic numbers up to 112, 118, 14 and 116 have been discovered. And discovered elements with atomic numbers 113, 115, 117 and 118 are not yet known, okay? So they will ask you the question about how you can find out the IUPAC name for the they will ask you a question based on the IUPAC name, okay? How to find out the IUPAC name? So I will give one example for this. Consider one problem, okay? Please note down the question and also the solution I will solve after writing the question, okay? What would be the IUPAC, okay, name and symbol for the element with atomic number 120. Okay, they are asking to find the name and symbol. As I explained you previously, how to find out the atomic, the symbol and the name, okay? So here 120 means just like, right, like this 120, okay? 120 roots for this. 1 is UN, 2 means by, okay? And 0 means nil. The last you should have respectively, okay, nil, and you have to add what I have explained, IUM. Just for everything you should add IUM here. The last one you just leave empty and write IUM. So after combining all this, what you will get? UN by nil IUM. This is the name, IUPAC name. Okay, I think you got what I am saying. These are the how I have to write from the roots for 120. These are the roots for 120. Okay, so last one you have to add like this and next. Okay, shall I move to next concept? The next concept is electronic configuration of element and the periodic table. Okay, so I will explain you in detail about electronic configuration of element and periodic table. So what do you mean by shells? What do you mean by orbitals? What do you mean by electronic configuration? I will give the answer for these questions, okay, in the next part.